Madame Lavoya, the greatest spiritist of our times. Tonight, you will see miracles before your very eyes as she reads your mind and connects the spirit
to the supernatural world. The telepathic vibrations are descending. Is there a young woman in the audience who has a connection with the seaside?
My name's Sandy.
Yes, yes, that is it. You are the one. Come, come.
Get it, Sandy.
Let me feel your inner vibes. I sense her name beginning with a D.
A brother, perhaps? I don't have any brothers.
A boyfriend?
No.
Cousin? Relative? Neighbour? Pet?
Maybe they have a happy name to go with a pig.
Oh, yes. Poor little Pippi, the hamster, has departed this world.
Not really. Her name was Poppy, and we had to get rid of her when we moved.
Poppy's hamster is calling out to you.
How do you know?
Madame Lavoya can talk to animals.
Marcus, I feel the spirits inside me.
Oh no, she's having one of her turns.
No, not gonna get there.
The demons are tormenting her.
Can we do something?
We mustn't break the link to the spiritual world. Miss Amboya, what do you see? Speak to us.
I feel a terrible, evil man bringing despair and misery.
Who is it, Madame?
Tell us. Cross is the word.
Genius, and you, are my assistant.
Yes, Dr. Gross.
When the world sees my creation, they will bow down before me.
Show me the monster, Doctor.
Well, I'd actually prefer it if you didn't refer to it as a monster. What I'm creating is more than a mere creature, more than artificial intelligence.
Oh, show me, Doctor, show me.
I am creating a mummy.
Don't mummies have Egyptian bandages wrapped around them?
Not that sort of mummy, you idiot! I am creating my own mother. The being you see before you will be my Mumsy Wumsy.
I don't understand.
Of course you don't. You grew up in the bosom of a family. Pretty me. An orphan child thrust from malevolent institution to malevolent institution with the likes of Tracy Beaker. I never knew what it was like to have a mother of my own.
You are so close to achieving the impossible.
I'm keeping my beautiful being alive through regular surges of electrical energy, thousands of volts running through her body, giving her life.
Your mother is almost complete. One final component is required. The transplant of a human brain.
Precisely. A brain worthy of being the mother of me. A brilliant, ambitious, imaginative.
The brain also needs to match the required blood group, DNA, and nerve structure. I have run search engines and analysis and have located the perfect match.
Ask! We have the perfect transplant!
There is a problem.
Oh, I am Dr. Gross, master of evil and invention. I laugh at problems. Ha 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 ha. Where is this woman with the perfect mind?
She is detained at Her Majesty's pleasure.
I beg your pardon?
She's in prison.
Awkward.
Serving a 5-year sentence.
So that means we have to break in to get her out?
I've heard of people breaking out of prison before, but not into prison.
Well, find a way. Our future evil success is at stake.
I am Delilah Blackheart. I have a plan.
Come on, Mumsy.
I expect discipline and order. Any prisoner that steps out of line will be locked in the cooler for a week. Is that understood?
Yes.
Good. Now, I hand you over to our chief chef, Menace McTavish.
Thank you, Miss Mangold. Today, ladies, we'll be having McTavish's special pig trotter stew. And yous are going to eat every last morsel. If I see any leftovers on your plate, I will hunt you down in the night and force these trotters down your neck. Have I made myself clear?
Yes.
Enjoy.
Well, I wouldn't give a plate for a sleeping dog's shit bidding.
Sausage and mash.
Fish and chips.
With mushy peas.
My mum's lamb biryani.
Hot noodles.
Really?
It's got to be better than McTavish's.
Fair enough.
Oh no, stew! You meant to make me!
You know the punishment if you don't!
Quit moaning and move on.
Yes, ma'am.
Go, gather round. Are we all set for tomorrow night's escaping?
Yes!
Once we're reunited with our stolen money, we are made for life, okay? Everyone talk to the plan.
I keep the lookout.
I tie all the sheets together.
I then file through the bars.
I disable the alarm system.
I abseil the ground floor.
I knock out the guards.
We all make a break.
Don't give anything away.
What's going on here?
We're just discussing our summer holiday plans, officer.
Well, this is a prison, not a WI club. Cut it out.
Yes, officer.
Oh, Diggy, what's the matter?
I'm worried, Shrink. McTavish and Stew always gives me collie bubbles. I don't think I can abseil diarrhea.
Okay, Fuzzy, you have to eat Diggy.
No!
Don't complain. Our freedom is at stake.
Stop chatting and get your dinner.
Excuse me? You just pushed in front of me?
Don't worry about it, Ruby. Do you know who I am?
Well, I know you're a very rude person who should be at the back of the queue.
Oh, sister, you're in trouble.
Ruby, just leave it, will you?
Slasher! I like to do nasty things for you with cutlery, and we've decided to join the queue.
And that's fine by me.
And me?
Not me! You need to learn some manners.
You're new here, aren't you?
That's right.
How long you in for?
5 years.
Well, if you want to last 5 days, I suggest you keep your mouth shut.
Did you know it's rude to boy?
Ah!
I don't believe you just did that.
Have you got a death wish?
What's going on here?
She sits over.
Is that right, Slasher?
Yes, that's right.
Well, you better
infirmary and get a doctor to check you over.
Oi. Bad for you.
Look forward to it.
Are you mad? Ruby, what are you doing?
I'm making a name for myself. Dinner time!
You said it was a fancy dress party,
so I made a slight mistake.
You made a big mistake. Not fancy dress, evening dress.
There was everything a girl could wish for that party. Free cocktails, free hors d'oeuvres, all seven gorgeous waiters, and we get thrown out.
I've never felt such an idiot.
I'm sure you have.
So what are we supposed to do now then?
Suppose we could save the world.
Very funny.
Well, no one will let us in dress like this. So I suppose it's a trip to the office and home to take my pizza.
Wow, the wildlife of a superhero.
I'm tingling with evil energy.
Can we help?
What a stroke of luck we run into you. We could really use your superpowers.
We're not real.
We all actually work in a supermarket.
Never mind that. If Madame Gaboria is right, and she usually is, we need all the help we can get. Will you join us?
Would you say, girls?
I'm up for an adventure. It's better than beer and pizza on the sofa.
Great. Follow me.
Bad feeling about this.
Don't worry, it's a foolproof plan. We break into the prison, locate the person with the perfect brain, kidnap her, take her back to our laboratory, perform the brain transference. What could be easier?
Fine, hand me the wire cutters.
I don't have the wire cutters. I thought you were bringing tools.
Don't be ridiculous! I was in charge of the sandwiches!
We'll just have to scale the fence.
Oh, this isn't working very well, is it?
You're not exactly SAS.
I struggle with vertigo.
Let's try again.
Here we go. And what are you doing?
Good evening, ladies. We were just out taking an evening stroll.
Rubbish, you're up to no good.
We're armed and dangerous.
We're the neighbourhood watchers, and we know villains.
We're just tourists taking in the sights.
Russian spies, I bet. Criminals at large.
Bricks and thieves.
Robbers with evil on their minds.
All right, I'll come clean.
Doctor?
My dear sister has been held captive within the walls of that prison for far too long. She was sentenced unjustly, I might say, for 200 years. I so missed the times you would stand around the family piano. I'd give anything for one last chorus of "Oh, Danny Boy." Oh, Danny Boy!
Don't worry, I've got a plan B.
Right, let's get out of here.
That poor man needs help. Let's bring him salvation.
Guards are in position here, I suppose. We need to get past him to sneak down this corridor to the upper floors. We saw through the laundering bars, shimmy down the wall, disable the sentry guard, and scale the fence. After that, we meet like our secret hideout to shout the stolen doll.
Yay! Josh, yeah, dollar.
But how are we going to get past the guards?
Don't worry, I've got a plan.
Oi, Ruby. We plan to escape tonight. Do you help us?
What's in it for us?
Show our stolen booty when you get out.
Yeah, booty, dollar.
We're in.
Great.
We need someone to create a diversion.
Keep the guards busy.
While we slip away into the night.
Are you up for that?
Consider it done.
Roll call, everyone out!
Oh no, if they find this map, we're done for.
Give it here.
All right, you bunch of miserable no-hopers. This is a routine search to make sure that no one is stealing contraband in my prison. My job is to make sure that your time here is as horrible as possible and that you are paying for your misdemeanors of the past.
Miss Mangle?
What is it?
It looks like a map of the prison.
So, Slasher Jenkins. Planning an escape, were you?
That's not mine. Must be planted on me.
Right. All privileges are withdrawn. You'll be facing toilet cleaning duty forthwith. And believe me, after Menace McTavish's pig trotter stew, that is a harsh punishment indeed.
I've been framed! There must be criminals in this prison!
Rescue, batch yourselves.
Things are not looking good. The whole electricity supply for the city is running out. We've got blackouts across the city.
It doesn't make sense. Something seems to be diverting megawatts away from the central distribution network.
It looks like someone's trying to bypass the main energy source, switching volts and raising the input.
Reversing the AC system.
And creating a vortex where electricity will power a single source, extracting its main energy away from external areas.
We need to find out who's doing this.
And why?
So, who are we looking for? Somebody who is about morals, and somebody who has brilliant technical skills.
Somebody who is a genius.
Let's go. Let me remind you that this is one of the toughest prisons in the country. This is no holiday camp. You'll hear no talk of rehabilitation from my lips. You are here to pay for your crimes, and I will ensure that your punishment is long and miserable. There's a phone call, Mrs. Mangle. Not now, Winston. I'm installing desolation and despair into the hearts of the criminals.
I think you might want to take it at the Home Office.
All right. Hello, sir. Oh, of course. Sir, I agree. thank you. Oh, goodbye. That's the Home Secretary.
Are you all right now?
They're sending in government inspectors. Oh, good. They see what a wonderful job you're doing.
Are you kidding?
This prison is based on corruption and deceit. I've been embezzling funds from the ministry for years. I've got a network of bribery for the prisoners, paying for luxury apartment cells. If the inspector's caught on, I'll be ruined.
Why are you telling me this?
I go down, you go down with me. We need to get rid of all these files.
And the inspector's here to conduct a full overview of the prison.
Welcome. Can I offer you a drink?
We don't drink on these.
Do you mind if I do?
Where is she going with those files?
What files?
Those files.
Those aren't files. Those are thank you cards.
Thank you cards.
From all of our prisoners.
That's most unusual.
This is an unusual prison. Our inmates are blessed with love and devotion for this institution. You might find a happier bunch of souls in the world.
We'll put that to the test. We can speak to the prisoners immediately.
Winston, keep them talking. I'm going to go and threaten the prisoners and bang the files.
Yes, ma'am.
Where is she going?
She's feeling the effect of our chef stew.
Right then, let the inspection commence.
Very well. Follow me.
My feet hurt!
So fly!
Do you think we're getting packed?
The vibes are strong.
Marcus, is it safe to go on?
I don't know. It may be dangerous. Perhaps you should turn back. I don't want you getting hurt.
No, I don't want to miss out on the adventure. Besides, I like being with you.
I feel the same.
Marcus, can I ask? Are you a Madame Foyer?
It's purely professional.
Here. Yes.
I feel evil and torment close within.
And how do you know?
Madame Lavoya has supernatural powers.
And when we meet this evil and torment,
what exactly will it look like?
Who knows? All I know is that the future of our world is at stake.
Dun, 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 dun!
Right, guys, follow me.
Wait, hold on a minute. Who are they?
I'm picking up high readings on the voltometer.
We must be getting closer to the energy source.
This area's a bit creepy. I mean, there are some more characters about.
Wait, I recognise them. You're Madame Lavoyer and Marcus Magnificent. I saw you in West Cliff Theatre in Clankton. Great show.
Thank you.
Here, are you on a spiritualistic journey at the moment?
Madame Foyer's got the vibe.
That's funny. I mean, we get strange reading.
Perhaps they're connected.
Do you think we should join forces? Good idea. Safety in numbers.
Later!
understand why we have to wear these silly outfits.
Two reasons. Firstly, there are always nuns in the school musical. And secondly, this is a perfect disguise for us to gain access to prison. No one will suspect two innocent-looking sisters of malevolent intentions. Now look, we're approaching the prison gates. Look nice and kind.
Do you know how to?
Well, just smile sweetly. Forget it. Best keep a straight face. Hello there. We are from the Holy Convent for Wayward Souls. We've come to bring peace and solace to the poor prisoners inside.
You're not on my list.
But the prison governor called us personally and asked us to come.
Like I said, you're not on the list.
Come now! It wouldn't be right to deny these women a chance of salvation through prayer, wouldn't it?
You're not on the list. You can't come in.
Can't we just kill her?
That's not the sort of thing that nuns do. Well, perhaps before we leave, we can bring comfort to your soul by sharing prayers with you.
Thank you. That's very kind of you, sister.
Now, hands together, close your eyes and bow your head. And don't open your eyes until you've prayed for all the people that you know. Now, listen up, you bunch of reprobates. The inspector's in, and we're going to get an outstanding report. That means on no account can the inspector see what life is really like inside this prison. I expect you to lie and cheat like the professional criminals you are. And may I remind you that anyone not following orders will be placed on toilet cleaning duty for the rest of their sentence. Now get acting. Oh, ladies! I do trust you're enjoying your tour of our delightful institution. So far, nothing exceptional. Well, may I welcome you to our library club?
One could argue that Jane Austen is using irony to criticise a patriarchal society.
We also have our drama society.
It is a far, far better thing that I do than I've ever done. It is a far, far better rest that I go to than I've ever known.
Oh, and very popular in our prison is our cookery club.
Dear ladies, we'll be preparing for your delicate soy porridge chicken with lemongrass rice, some thyme and leaves and lime wedges.
We also have our still life art class.
I must say, Mandel, this is rather impressive.
Well, you haven't even seen our feast of the stomp, the music society.
Everybody in the
You know, sometimes I do really surprise myself with how truly amazing I am.
What are you doing to me?
I'm giving you a new future.
But I don't have much to look forward to.
You are taking part in one of the most important moments in modern science. Today we will see the creation of a mortal being.
And what part do I play in this?
I'm transferring your brain into the brain of my creation. It's a great privilege for you.
Well, forgive me for not letting a party happen. It's just I get the feeling this isn't going to be much fun.
Oh, well, losing your mind is never fun, but you'll be reborn in the body of my mumsy onesie.
Lovely. So what happens to me?
I'm afraid you'll just become one of my many cast-offs. I've had many, many donors provide vital parts for my creation. They remained lost and forgotten. It's sad, but it's the price you pay for scientific magnificence.
And I guess there's no chance of me trying to persuade you to change your mind.
I'm too evil and twisted for any last-minute change of heart. Your fate is sealed. My assistant Blackheart will now explain the procedure to you.
Oh, is this where you tell me I'm not going to be the thing?
On the contrary, the brain transference procedure is extremely painful. I'm afraid you will be in agony.
I mean, I've eaten many compassions, Jim. Can't be as bad as that.
Dr. Groves, the generator is building to maximum strength. I've diverted energy sources from across the city. We will reach full power very soon.
And then, my beautiful creature, you shall come alive, and I will be the most famous man on Earth. Now, I want to look my best for my inevitable TV appearances, so I'm just going to go change into something a little more chic.
I'll monitor the generator. We'll leave you to think about your impending lobotomy. After all, it is the last thinking you'll do. Hey, don't rush back.
Any sign? Nothing. Keep searching. Ruby's in trouble and we need to find her.
Those gnomes are on the run. Let's get them.
I don't understand. That poor man's just disappeared.
But he hasn't been ringing out for me, sister.
So much sadness in the world.
Let's not give up. He has a heart of gold and we must help him.
Ladies, neighborhood watcher. Our found one's close and no one's asylum.
Another mystery.
What's happened to the gnomes?
I think we all know, don't we?
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Alien abduction! Wow!
No doubt about it!
There are two nuns in their underwear on an alien ship right now.
Same place along to our mystery man.
Let's keep searching.
Need to keep your eyes on the ground.
And nothing.
Keep your eyes on the sky.
Let's go. We're free at last. But let's split up. Meet back on the way to the end today. Share the spoils.
Hang on, there's a problem. Ruby's gone missing.
Wait, what do you mean?
She's been kidnapped and taken from the prison.
So, she's in trouble.
Well, obviously she's in trouble.
Is that our problem?
I think it is.
But we've finally broken free. We have to split up and get far away.
But Ruby needs our help.
She did help us escape.
We can't do what we need.
All for one?
And one for all.
Let's find her before it's too late.
We've escaped from prison! Free at last!
We can go to wherever we want. I'm thinking Greece, Kupcha, and the Blue!
Oh, we're not going anywhere yet. We have unfinished business to attend to.
What do you mean?
Nobody is going anywhere until we settle our score with Ruby.
Oh, come on, Sasha. This is our only chance to get away. And yet again, you're ruining it.
Greece can't wait! I'm revenge and you diamonds are going to help me.
The police will be on to us.
I am not going anywhere until our goal will be made to pay. Now let's get going.
I'm starving.
Time for a snack at more, I think.
No time to waste. We've got to find Ruby.
It's easier to save lives on a full stomach.
I work better when I'm not hungry.
To be honest, I could dinner before Ruby.
Even a takeaway would do. Remember the criminal code of honor? We put our system above ourselves.
Let's go!
We've got search parties all across the city. So far there's no sign.
We'll try harder with them.
If we don't find those prisoners and get them back behind bars,
I'm ruined. No career, no OBE. Miss Mangle, what's going on?
Everything's under control, I assure you.
Mangle, half your prison inmates are at large from the city. One of them's been abducted by a nun. I'd say you've got everything to worry about.
When everyone hears about this, they'll be held to pay.
It is just a hiccup, I assure you.
Round them up!
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone's run away before eating my stew. That makes me very, very angry.
Generators everywhere beginning to lose power.
We must. The light's going out across the city. All the power seems to be surging one way. Too much buildup in one location could result in a massive overload and the explosion! This is a race against time.
So also even greater, this amount of electricity could provide the force to bring energy to inanimate bodies.
I don't understand.
There is great evil in the force here, and this evil can change life forms.
Are you talking Walking Dead?
Zombies!
Exactly.
There's no time to lose. The Lord Thomas points this way. Lead on.
So very soon, I'll be you. Will be me. I haven't quite worked that out, but we'll be together. I've got to say, I never did see you with blue hair. I was hoping someone was going to come and rescue me. I guess that's unlikely. I don't know why the doctor chose my brain to transfer into your mind. Maybe he thinks a criminal's mind is compatible with his own. Trouble is, I'm not really a criminal. I'm not saying I'm a good two-shoes, but I didn't do what they said I did. The jury got it wrong. That doesn't matter now. Looks like this is the end for me. So much for Ruby's life.
Oh, do stop feeling sorry for yourself.
Excuse me, but my life's about to end. Allow me a little self-pity. You were playing a major role in Dr. Gross's groundbreaking experiment. You should be honoured. Sorry, I'm not over the moon at the prospect of annihilation. You should be excited for your new life. I am. You're not about to lose your mind.
I would give anything to be in your position.
Really?
Dr. Gross is a genius.
He is brave and handsome. You should see it as an honour to support this experiment. That explains why you are so angry.
What do you mean?
You're in love with Gross.
Don't be ridiculous.
You're in love with him, but he can't reciprocate the love.
Of course he can.
All he wants is a mother, and you feel rejected.
Enough.
Poor Delilah Blackheart, how it must hurt to spend every waking moment with the man you love. But all he does is prove to his creature.
One day he'll realise what he's been missing.
I wouldn't hold your breath. He seems a one-woman guy.
The power suction is almost complete. A few moments and the brain transfer can begin. I'm going to switch to manual override. May I remind you that escape is futile? Beneath the source of power, with this much electricity concentrated in one place, there's a chance the whole place could blow.
We're walking below a time bomb!
Are we going to die?
I'm sure we'll be fine.
Sandy, are you okay?
What is that?
As we thought, zombies!
Are they dangerous?
Deadly!
Then let's get out of here!
Don't move! If you move, the zombies will be stimulated to follow us!
No, they have an injury response. If you pretend like you're a zombie, they won't recognize you as dinner.
There's an influx of super energy. The power is surging.
Everything is about to change. Pretend you're a zombie.
Pointless! We're never going to find Ruby!
We've searched all over!
We use our cunning and our courage.
I don't think I have that much of either.
Hush, I hear someone. Let's hide. Oh.
Got a bad feeling about this.
That's because you ate too much of men's for the tavern's stew.
Not that sort of bad feeling, Diamond.
Something strange is going on. She's close, I can tell. Physically we switch. I think we should split up.
I don't think that's a good idea, Sasha.
This is a horror story. People always split up in horror stories.
Oh, see if you can find her. If not, be back here. Let's go.
Oh, goodness sake!
Ha ha ha!
At last. After years of experiments, I am finally ready to complete my creation. Soon, my beautiful creature, you will have the brain you always deserved, and I will have the money I've always wanted.
You won't get away with this, Gross.
Of course I will. I'm a genius. Now stop your complaining and accept your fate. Blackheart, are you ready?
Ready, Doctor.
Turn on Electro.
Electrodes, check.
Electric current in exchange mode.
Exchange mode, check.
Evil facial expression.
Check.
Fine. Let the brain change commence!
No! Stop right there!
Who are you?
I am Madame Lavoyer, spiritualist and tormentor of evil demons.
And I am Marcus the Magnificent, actor, singer, all-round entertainer.
And I'm Sandy, receptionist and phone operator. And I'm Wonder Woman,
Catwoman,
Supergirl,
Batgirl, She-Hulk.
And we're from the Electricity Board.
I'm not afraid to
Water looks bright.
The voltometer is back to normal. Well done, everyone. Your timely actions have prevented a major disaster.
The entire city was about to explode. You saved us.
Ruby, are you still Ruby?
Yes, I think so.
Don't panic. We're here. Not you again.
Dr. Gross, you're alive.
Hands off, ladies. He's mine.
Have these terrible people been nasty to you?
Yes. Yes, they have.
Then we're done with them. You all have the citizens arrest.
You idiot.
He's the evil one.
You must think we were born yesterday.
Anyway, you can't arrest us.
We've already been arrested.
And charged. And sent to prison.
Mm-hmm. And you're all going back there. Oh. But what do you expect? This isn't some namby-pamby musical where everybody gets a happy ending. This is real life.
Well, at least save Ruby from a fate worse than death.
All right. I am feeling lethal. I want to see her. Where is she?
Looks like you spoke too soon.
I want to hear the sound of crushing bones.
We need to protect Ruby fast.
Come on, everyone. Let's all stand up to slash it together.
Or not. Don't worry. I can look after myself. Looks like you might not need to. It could be over for all of us.
I'm afraid not!
This is it!
Actually, we're not zombies.
I beg your pardon?
We don't want to kill you. For the victim of Dr. Gross's experiment, you're being cast aside.
Left to wander the world,
alone and uncared for. We're following you for a hug, because no one wants us.
Lost and forgotten.
We just want to be loved.
Successful neighborhood.
after me.
I'm in the mood for romance. I'm all yours.
Wait, aren't we forgetting something?
Mason Tavish!
She looks angry.
Vicious.
Mean.
This could lead to trouble.
Looks to me like you're having a party.
Yes.
Well, if you're having a party, I'd better bake the cake.
Oh. And you're all gonna eat it, understood?
Yes.
Let the
Thank you, sir, thank you. Now, this wouldn't have all been possible without some really important people that we'd like to invite up now to say thank you for all of us giving us the opportunity to put the show on for the past 2 nights. It's been a real good fun and something we've all really enjoyed, hasn't it?
Yes!
So, first person we'd like to ask up is Donna. Donna is photographer extraordinaire. Next, we'd like to ask up someone who choreographed one of the dances, please, Miss Paul.
Oh.
Next, we'd like to invite up the main choreographer, Miss Fanna. And most importantly, acoustic guitar playing extraordinaire, Neil Whitehead. Have a lovely evening and get home safe. Thank you very much.